So we will start defining what does Lailatul Qadar means. The word Lailatul Qadar here has two parts for it. The first part is Laila, the second part is Al-Qadar. Okay. So Al-Laila, it means night. Okay. So we are sure that Laila, it is in the night. This it is it occurs in the night. Okay. And Al-Qadar, there are several definitions for Qadar. What does Qadar means? Okay. What is meant by Al-Qadar? And the first definition is that Al-Qadar can be defined as honor. If you were to say a person dhu qadrin azim, it means dhu sharafin azim. Means it's a person who has honor. A person who is described as a person who is honorable person. Okay. And this is can be understood from the surah itself, the surah Al-Qadr. Allah says in surah Al-Qadr, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. Verily we have sent the Quran in the night of Qadr. So the first honor for this night is that the Quran is revealed in Laylatul Qadr. And second, Allah says, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. And what will make you know what the night of Qadr is? Okay, what will make you know what the Qadr is? Allah have seen this type of methodology or this type of siyaq is present a lot in the Quran. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. And the other verses like Surah Al-Infitara, Surah Al-Infitar, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ ثُمَّ مَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ. What do you know about the day of judgment? Okay, Allah says. And also Allah says in Surah Al-Qariyah, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْقَارِيَةِ. Allah says in Surah Al-Qariyah, Al-Qari'ah, مَا الْقَارِيَةِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْقَارِيَةِ. What do you know about the day of judgment, Al-Qari'ah? And a few other verses, even a Surah Al-Haqa, Malhaqa, wama adraka malhaqa. A lot of Quran, Allah have mentioned this. So whenever a verse has this type of siyaq, this type of way of presenting, it creates glorify. It glorifies or it magnifies the thing which is coming after that. Okay. So Allah says, wama adraka ma laylatul qadr. What do you know about laylatul qadr? Allah says, laylatul qadri khairu min alfi shahar. That particular night, this Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. Okay, so it's another honor. This night, particular act of worship is better than 1,000 months. And next, another honor which creates to this night is that Tanazzulul Malaikatu Warruhu Fiha Bi'idhni Rabbihim. In this night, the angels will descend and the ruh will descend. Ruh meaning Jibreel alayhi salam will descend in this blessed night. And as you know, Jibril alayhi salam does not come to the earth after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam except on one particular night. It is the night of Al-Qadr. Okay. As you know, Jibril is one of the chief of the angels. And he will never descend except for revelation during Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam time. And now he is coming to the earth. And he is coming in this honored night. And lastly, this night will be filled with peace. Salam. Peace. Salamun hiya hatta matla'il fajr. And there will be peace in this night. And these are the few things that we have highlighted. It creates honor to this night. So that's why the ulama define this night as the night of honor. Second definition. Al-Qadr can be defined as decree or destiny. As you know, there is our arkan of iman is to believe al-qadr khairihi wa sharrihi, to believe in the decree, the good thing and the bad thing, okay, that is decreed upon us. And al-qadr here, it means decree or destiny, okay, because Allah says in surah ad-dukhan, fiha yufraku kullu amrin hakim. In this night is decreed every matter of ordainment, okay. That means the decree for what will happen next year will be decreed on this night. Okay, so it is named as the night of decree. And lastly, this Laylatul Qadr can be defined as a night of restriction. Because Allah says in the Quran, وَلْيُنْفِقْ ذُو سَأَةٍ مِّن سَأَتِهِ. Allah says in Surah At-Talaq verse 7, وَلْيُنْفِقْ ذُو سَأَةٍ مِّن سَأَتِهِ وَمَنْ كُدِرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْكُهُ فَلْيُنْفِقْ مِمَّا أَتَاهُ اللَّهِ. A rich man should spend according to his means. Okay, this in the bab of giving nafaqah to his wife. Okay, giving allowance to a person's wife. Okay, فَلْيُنْفِقْ ذُو سَأَةٍ مِّن سَأَتِهِ. A person who's rich, he should give according to his means. وَمَنْ كُدِرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْكُهُ فَلْيُنْفِقْ مِمَّا أَتَاهُ اللَّهُ. A person who's restricted of his provision, restricted of his resources, he should give according to his capability. Okay, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما أتى الله. Allah does not burden a soul according to more than his ability. Okay, so from here we can understand that qadr can mean restricted. Okay, and what does that concerns here, restriction here? So ulama has views that in this night it will be restricted. There are few categories of people who will be restricted. They are the shaitan, the devils, and the people who are ahlul ma'asi, the people who commit sins. These people, this category of people will be restricted at this night. Okay? Because this night, all Muslims will be striving to do good deeds. Okay? And shaitan will not be able to control the people who want to do good deeds. Okay? So, the shaitan and the wrongdoers will be restricted in this night. Okay? And it is also said that it is called constrained or restricted is because at this night, many angels, multiple of angels will be descending to the earth. Okay? And it is said in a hadith that the angels found in this earth on Laylatul Qadr will be more than the stones or pebbles. Okay, that means there will be too many angels, and the earth will be constrained or restricted. Okay.